Hi, Aditya here from JL Softech. In this session, we are going to discuss the creation of credit control area, business area, functional area, consultation business area, financial management area, segment and profit center. These are the things that we are going to discuss now in this session. So let's first start off with the defined credit control area, because you already know company and company code. So I'll take up this one, credit control area. In the credit control area, I'm creating new entries, and in this I'm taking this as VPR2, currency is INR. And what exactly is the significance of credit control areas? Here we are going to define how much amount to which we can give the credit to the customer. So you can also put the risk management category. Risk category is like we have to create the separate risk category for this, and then we can put it here. But just you can also mention the amount here. This much amount is the maximum thing that up to which we can give the limit to the customer. And fiscal year variant also, we can mention the fiscal year variant that we have mentioned, we have created. So normally we run VP, April to March, special periods. And update also we can give the update. So it is like 0, 1, 2, 15 and 18, so different types of updates. And if you just keep it blank, there's no update, so you're keeping it blank now, and just save it. So new requirement for process, just say okay. This has been saved successfully. So VPR2 is a credit control area for which we have given certain limit. So whenever we go ahead and give the controlling, the customer accounts receivable submodule, in that this will play a significant role what we have done now. And then we'll go for the defined business area. So business area, click on new entries, and in this the business area is VPR3. Chennai. Okay, I'll take it as VPR5 is a business area. We process Chennai, and I'll take VPR6 as another location like Bangalore, and just say save. So we are creating two business areas. We can have n number of business areas under a company code, and then we are going ahead with the functional area. So define functional area. In this, click on new entries, and in this functional area is VPR5. We process functional area is like SD module, MM module, or something like the sales module. You can just say we can segregate the data between sales, material management, all this stuff. So I'm just clicking on the save now. Say okay. Once it's been done, we go ahead, we come back, and functional areas is done. So maintain consolidation business area, just click on this maintain consolidation business area, click on new entries, and this business consolidation area is a VPRG. Consolidation area. Okay, just say okay, save it. Once you save it, you need to assign the business areas that we have done till now. We need to assign it to this business consolidation area. This will come under the assignment part. So in the assignment part, if you check the financial accounting, in this you're already aware of assigning company code to company, company code to credit control area. Assigning company to credit control area is what we will do it now, because just now we created a credit control area, we'll assign it. And then we have business area to consolidation area, company code to financial management area, and assign profit center to company code. So these are the things that we have to do in the assignment part. So first let us finish off this creation. So we have created, first we have created the credit control area, then we created the company code, business area. So let's create, we have already created the business area, we also created the consolidation business area, we created the functional area. So what was the functional area name that we have just now done? VP VPR VPR 8 or VPR G VPR and consolidation business area. We need to check that. So for maintain functional management area, so just click this, and in this we already have VPRO, so we'll just go for VPR1. So new entries. Financial management area is a part of the financial FICO module. So VIP. Financial management, create defense segment. So defense segment, we'll get for new entries VPSE. We press this, save it, and then back here, define profit center. Click on this profit center. Okay, so before creating the profit center, we must have a controlling area in place. So let us go ahead and create the controlling area. So let's go to the maintain controlling area, copy and delete the controlling area, maintain controlling area. In this, we have couple of controlling areas here already existing. So let's go ahead and click on the new entries, and in the new entries, I just want to click company. Controlling area is equal to company code, so that automatically the company code will come here. So I'll just click on this. So this is VPRO, and that's it. So all the credit controlling area company code configurations, whatever we have mentioned, will be copied to the controlling area. Company code to controlling area. So controlling area same as company code. Click on save. Save. So once we have done this controlling area, we will be able to go ahead and create the profit center. In fact, for creating the profit center, we can create a cost center and then we can replicate that as a profit center. We're going to do in both ways. Now let's go ahead and create the cost center. Create cost center. This is a create cost center screen, and in this we are going to give VPRO as the controlling area. And once we give the controlling area, we are assigning VPRC or VPCC. We can also put as VPRO only to make it simple. So valid from, so the date is tomorrow's date. Okay, cost center. So whatever is the cost center we have, we need to if you want to take the reference of some other cost center, you can do that, or controlling area also we can do that. But just say enter. Okay, I'll just come back to this. Yeah, okay, so when I'm discussing the controlling part, I'll discuss about the create cost centers, because we have to have maintain the hierarchies. And in profit center also, we need to have some prerequisites. So let us go ahead with the creation of segment. Did we create the segment now? Yes. Yeah. Okay, so let's go ahead with the assignments now. So in the assignments, we'll go to the financial accounting. In this, assign company code to company, we already done that. Company code to credit control year, the credit control year that we just now created is what we need to do. So position VPRO, for this the credit control area is VPRO. So we can have this, you know, the credit control area just now we created is VPR1. So we can either go for VPR1 VPRO. So if you just double click on this, that will be updated with the old one. In fact, if you have not assigned any controlling area, it by default takes it as blank. So we need to fill it up. And then we have the business consolidation area. So go for the business consolidation area, and in that business area, VPR5. So for VPR5, the business consolidation area would be VPRG, and here also we have VPRG. This is the business consolidation area that we have. Okay. So once we have back, assign company code to financial management area. Click on this company code to financial management area. In that company code to financial management area, we have. Okay. So this is company code to financial management area. So company code is, let's click on this VPRO. And the financial management area is, we can just browse it, whatever financial management area we have created just now. So that was VPR9. You can double click on this and click on save. Then back, and we have once we create the profit center, we can assign the profit center to company code. So the transaction codes for all these things which we have done just now, okay, just get it like this. So here, creation of business area is OX03, and business consolidation area is OCC1, maintain functional management area OF01, profit center we have not done, that we'll do it later in the controlling part. Then we have the assigning company code to create control is OB38, business area to consolidation area is OBB6, and company code to financial area is OF18. Okay, and next we are going to have something like, yeah, the profit center is like a bridge between the controlling and finance, as already discussed. Okay, we'll create a segment now. One more segment, define company, click on new entries, and I'm creating something like VPR8. We press this segment, save. That's it. So this is how we are creating a segment. Segment is simple. The way we create the segment is simple, but later we need to assign this segment to the company code wherever it is required, so that we can map all the transactions to it. So here, then we have in the financial accounting global settings. In the financial accounting global settings, we have activate new general ledger accounting, company code, business area, fiscal year. You have the business area here. Enable business area balance sheet. Check display authorization of business area. General ledger accounting. GL accounts. I think we have all done all this. Revised chart of accounts is like modify anything existing. Edit chart of accounts, assign company code to chart of accounts also we have done, account groups also we have done, retained earnings account